it's Ali here from topgurus.com. How are you all? This is amazing. We're carrying on this journey of WordPress here, diving deeper and deeper and deeper into it. We're understanding the ins and outs of WordPress. And today in this wonderful tutorial, we're going to be talking about posts. Now, common question I get asked is posts, pages, what's the difference? Why have they got two separate things? So posts, think of them more as like blogging. More sort of interactive, where you got like comments there, you got stuff down the right hand side, affiliate, you know, like sign up newsletters, you're writing about a particular topic, let's say top 10 reasons to watch topgurus.com, things like that. But pages are more generally, what I would use them for anyway, is working like service-based websites or e-commerce websites or building things like home, about, contact, FAQ, terms and conditions. These types of things are generally created with pages. Posts are generally, like I said before, generally like blogging, article type content. They're very interactive, stuff like that. So let's dive in and I'll show you how to create posts, how to delete posts, how to use posts, how to work with posts, how to do anything with posts. So we're going to come up here and we're going to come into our admin section and come down to posts. Now, by default, if this is a fresh installation, then you'll always be provided with a Hello World post. They just stick in these fake posts. We can delete that. There's no need to keep that. We will delete it. But before I delete it, I'll just sort of show you around this section a little bit first. So like everything in WordPress, we have all these different types of actions. We can bulk edit, bulk move to trash, which works well when you're working with a lot of different types of posts. You might end up with lots of stuff in here, like posts and pages might get really big, and bulk deleting is a really handy tool. You would just select the ones that you want and then you would apply move to trash, you would apply the action. You also can filter by date, by month. So let's say you knew you had a blog post set in January, you'd be able to filter that if that option was there. You can also filter by categories. I'll show you how to use categories and stuff like that. In the next part of this tutorial. Down here on the right, you've got search blog posts. If you know the name of the blog post, just stick it in there and it will bring up just that blog post. Great filtering way of diving deep in. Now at present, you look at this and think, well, what do I want that for? But when you've got like 15 pages of blog posts, trust me, search features are well handy to have. Over the top here, every time you hover over the main title word, you'll notice you're displayed with edit, quick edit, trash, and view. Now, depending on plugins, sometimes you install plugins that will add more, like I like to install a duplicate plugin, which duplicates the blog post or the page. So you might say duplicate here, it might say add to Elementor here. It can say different things when you hover over, like I say, depending on what you're putting in as a plugin. So when you, for example, you choose quick edit just allows you to make quick little changes here and there. You can change the title, the slug. The slug is the URL. So that's what you call the link, www.nameyourwebsite.com/hello-world-test. That's as an example. Dates we'll talk about when we actually make some edits. You've got different categories, which I'll show you how to create. We have different tags, which I'll also show you how to create and explain them as well. And you have just some other stuff in here. Now, these are just quick edits. This is what the name is, quick edits. You don't necessarily, unless you want to change titles or slugs, really want to spend much time in there. You can also go to trash, so I can trash this, meaning that I can put this in the bin. When I click trash, and then I come back to all, you'll notice there's nothing in here. But when I go to the trash link, you'll notice I have some other ones in here. So if I make a mistake, which I've done many times, I put something in the bin, in the trash by mistake, you can come into the trash link, check mark it, or if it's just one, you can just click on restore. That means now when I come back to all my blog posts, you'll notice that it's back, which comes in handy. If you want to delete, like you don't want that thing ever again on this server, you just come back to trash, you click on the tick box here, or if it's just individual one, you can click delete permanently. If it's multiple, remember you can do the bulk action, delete permanently, and then you would apply that action, and that means that has been deleted off your website, okay? And you'll notice the trash has disappeared. Other things we have here is who was the author? So it was myself, but you might have other people helping run your blog or your website, so it might have their name. The category that this is in, this blog post, the tags that I'm using, which we'll talk about, and when it was last modified, and whether it has a comment or not, what type of comment. Most web installation WordPress for the first time always comes with one page, one post, one comment. They just like to add stuff in there. So let's go inside of it. You can get inside of it by clicking Hello World, or you can just click on Edit. So I'm going to click on Edit, and I'm going to come in, and this is what you're displayed with. Now, we're using the latest WordPress, which is 2021. This is the look that it has at the moment. The top part here might look different if you're using an older installation of WordPress. This is a more modern version. So up here you have where you can add blocks. Blocks are a way that you can add things to your WordPress to create the actual blog post. Later on, we're going to be using something called Elementor, where we're going to be designing a lot more powerful. I find this way of creating blog posts very limiting. I want to have full control, full power, and I'm going to show you later on exactly how you can do that. But for now, when you install WordPress, this is like the standard editing available. You can add different types of things, different features, imagery, galleries, videos, things like that. This is a layer system, so you can move things up, or you can just direct yourself to a specific part on side of the theme. So if I want to get to the paragraph, I click paragraph and it will allow me to edit. Here is the main title. And when I click on this, you'll notice on the right here, it brings up the URL. URL being the name of your website.com/ whatever you want to put, Hello World Test. You can have a title, but you can also have a different URL. So I could put here, Ali. That means the name of the page is called Hello World, the H1, for example, but the actual URL can be different from that. Over here on the right, you can save this as a draft, which is cool, so you don't actually have to make it live. You can just save it, you know, get your thoughts out. You can preview it so you can see what it looks like. When it comes to publishing it, gives you some options. You can either publish it public, meaning everyone can see it, publish it private, which means only certain types of people can see it. Okay, let me just cancel that for a sec. Or you can publish it with password. So you give someone a password and then they can log into this page. Only people with that password can see it. I'm just gonna cancel that. Those are quite handy, a way of publishing. I really quite like those, the ways you can do different things with them. This clock allows you to bring over the right sidebar and turn it off. And then you have some different options what you can turn on. You've also got some welcome guides and help sections down here by clicking these three dots here. So you have posts and blocks. I'm just going to close some of this stuff up just so I can show you what it is. So you have the status. This gives you information on the status of the post. Actually, under publish, I forgot to show you, you have where you can set when you want to publish this. So let's say I've created content for the next couple of months, which I like to do. We both like to have content done in one period of time. And then you can come in and just simply choose every week I want a different post put on. So you just set the date and time for those blog posts. Very powerful, really very handy. Also good, let's say you're going on holiday or something like that. You can just come in here and choose what dates you want stuff put on. We use this feature a lot when we're away or when we're mass producing different types of content and want something to come out every day. Instead of us having to actually be there, we just time everything. I'm just gonna come out of that again. So the status and visibility just shows you that stuff, visible, dates published, different options for the template from the theme that we're using. Showed us how many revisions we've made. This is, like I said, the permalink. Permalinks are, they're called permalinks, but they're like the URL link, everything after your domain name. So tupgurus.com/ whatever's in this box will get displayed. That's how people will find this particular page. Categories, I'm gonna come back and show you that. I'm gonna show you how to create categories. Tags are the same. You can just open and close these just by clicking on these arrows. You can add a featured image, so you can add an image to this blog post. Again, we're going to be doing later on creating websites in a different way. You can create this way. There's nothing wrong with creating this way. It's just I want full control over the WordPress website, and I want to make sure it's as sexy and beautiful as possible. And I do that by using Elementor, which we're definitely going to be doing a course on. Excerpts are bits of text, like depending on what your theme is, depending if this option is available or not, you can have like mini blocks of text explaining what this post is about. They get displayed in different parts of your theme. Discussions, these are, do you want to allow comments on your blog post or do you want pingbacks and trackbacks? These are ways that they send out to other websites to let them know that they're connected. And then you have your post attributes, which is dependent on your theme, what you want your theme to be. Full width, sidebar, maybe no header and footer, things like that. But we're going to go over more of that later. At present, I just want to show you around. So that's pretty much the blog post section. If you click on this W at the top left here, this will bring you back. Yep, I'll just leave. We don't really want to save anything. You also notice under posts, we have some different options. We have all posts, which when you click that, is this page that we've been looking at. Add new post, which is exactly the same as this button under all posts. You can click add new, and then you can create your own post. I'm just going to go back to W. Or you can click here, add new, and that will take you to the same page, add new post. You also have something called category. Now, categories are only dependable upon posts. In this particular option, when you have it inside a post, when they're talking about categories, they're talking about post categories, not page categories, post categories. You can create any category you want. You can name it whatever you want. So let's just put, I don't know, Photoshop tutorials without making Photoshop tutorials. If I leave this blank, which I will, you'll notice how it gets displayed. This is a parent category, so let's say I want to put Photoshop tutorials inside of build website tutorial. I can change it, make build website to become the parent. The parent is the main category. The subcategories will then be put inside of it. This category will then be put inside of the build website. I can add a description to explaining what this category is, but I'm going to click add new category. Now you'll notice it has a line here. This indicates that Photoshop Tutorials is inside of Build Website. You'll also notice that I didn't put a slug and it just created the two words, Photoshop Tutorials, and it made it to create its own URL. Remember, slugs are URLs. You'll also notice that it took away the space. URLs, you don't have spaces. You need to make sure you have these dashes. You can have a separate one. I could put in here YouTube videos as an example. But I want my URL to be different. Maybe I want it like top 10 amazing YouTube videos. So I have a title, so the category name, so when I bring it up or when it gets displayed on the website will be called YouTube videos, but the URL to it will be top-10-amazing-youtube-videos. I'm gonna make that to be its own main category, meaning it's the parent, and I'm going to add a new category. So you'll now notice I have the YouTube here. I can then view it. And when I view it, you'll notice that the URL is what I wrote inside of that slug, but the name of the category is YouTube videos. These are really powerful because you want sometimes the name of the category to be one thing, but the URL to get there, good SEO keywords, you can change that. So when it comes to posts, pretty much you want to create categories first. You want to have them display because when you come to create posts, you're going to want to choose which category you want your post in. I'll show you that in a sec. We also have tags here. Tags are similar. So let's say, for example, you have a tutorial website like we have, and we do tutorials on WordPress, and we're doing multiple tutorials all over the place on WordPress, putting it on different posts. Well, we can tag inside of those posts a tag called WordPress. So anytime we associate that tag to any one of the posts, it will then, when someone clicks on WordPress tag inside of the actual post, it will take them to all the WordPress posts that we have WordPress tag associated to. I'll show you that in a sec, but you can create the same one. I can just put one here, Photoshop, leave that, add description, and you'll notice I've got a new one. So let me come back to a post and show you actually how you assign these. So I'm going to come back to all posts. I'm just going to use this Hello World post as an example. I'm just going to click on edit. Now down here on the right, if you don't see it, it's because of this clog here. You just click on that. That's the settings clog. You can come down to categories and you'll now notice that we have new categories in here. Build website, I can put them in all categories. I can just put them in one category, it's up to me. So I'm gonna stick this one in YouTube category. You also notice that we have the tags. Now, tags don't get displayed like categories. You just have to start typing them in. So for example, I'm gonna start typing in WordPress, and you'll notice now I have the option of tutorials and WordPress. If the tag is not saved inside of the tag section, it won't show up. So if I put SEO, nothing will happen because I don't have a tag called SEO. Okay, I'm just gonna delete that out. And then I'm just gonna publish this. I'm gonna publish it now. And let's go and have a look at this post. I'm gonna view the post. So you'll notice inside this post, we have the category, which is YouTube videos. So when I click on that, it'll take me to YouTube videos. And there's only one YouTube video in here called Hello World. You also have the tag sections where I have tutorials and WordPress. So anytime someone clicked on WordPress, I'm just gonna open that up in a new tab by control command clicking. Anytime I have a tag to any one of my posts or pages with the word WordPress, then they will display inside of here all of my WordPress posts, okay? Very powerful if you've got a big site. If you haven't got a big site, then maybe you don't wanna navigate so much, but I quite like using them sometimes. So that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna come back into my admin and I'm just gonna delete out these. And then the last thing, let's say we didn't want Hello World, we just wanna get rid of that. We just go click on it, click on trash. It then gets added to the trash. I'm gonna come to trash, I'm gonna click on it. I'm actually gonna just click here because there's only one of them, delete permanently. And that is how you work with posts. So posts are awesome, like I say, for blogging, creating like article content. This is amazing. In the next tutorial, we're gonna be talking about pages, how pages work, similar to this, but also like maybe have a little few different types of settings. Thanks guys and girls for watching this tutorial. I hope it's been of great value to you. If you like these tutorials, please subscribe or click the like button. Leave any comments you want below, we'll get back to you. And if you wanna be notified when the next awesome tutorials are coming out, simply click that bell and then that will let you know when we're adding content. We are adding a lot of content, there's a lot more coming. So great to see you all. Hope you all have a wonderful day and evening, and I'll catch you guys and girls in the next tutorials. Laters, everyone.